Hey there, and welcome to Big Freakin Toys. I'm Super Dupert.
And I'm Pop-Tart.
And in this installment, we'll be looking at Hot Toys' deluxe figure from the 1989 superhero film, Batman. This is MIchael Keaton's portrayal of the Batman.
So grab your fan club cards, your Dakota rings, and let's get started.
I want you to tell all your friends about me.
What are you?
I'm Batman.
Genius helped to change Batman's status to a serious comic book character by placing him in a dark and gritty environment, giving him a brooding attitude and serious relationship issues.
And even though comic book fans really didn't care for the casting of MIchael Keaton at first, the bold visual style and character design won them over and helped raise the bar for many future Batman films to come.
Hot Toys released this first DX figure from the license back in 2012, and it was our first experience with their deluxe figure line, so let's check it out. Hot Toys has become the standard for large-scale collectible figures. Their packaging has become more collector-friendly, and many companies are following in their footsteps. With the DX line, the packaging reaches a new level of awesome. Not only are they a lot sturdier than the standard boxes, they also have nice little features like magnetic flaps on the lids, interior color schemes that complement the character, foam trays with contour cut holes to keep the figures safe, and cool little add-in features that make the packaging more than just a shipping container. And as always, it's super easy to get the product in and out of the box without damaging either one. This box has a nice metallic outer finish, but it didn't wow us too much, except for the faint picture of Batman on the front and the side panel advertisement for the Batmobile from the same film. We were more impressed with the inside of the box, with the cool contrasting yellow color and the well-packed and protected parts. The top foam tray is framed by a cutout panel that shows off the figure and some of the cool features and props he comes with. So although it did make us do cartwheels at first, the inside of the box does a great job of packing and protecting and makes the initial unboxing of the product a pleasure. It's a welcome change from the plastic trays and flat boxes, and that's why we gave it a solid 4 out of 5.
Creating a spot-on likeness on a 6-scale figure can be tricky, especially when the figure only has half his face showing. With this fellow, it's especially challenging because he only has one head sculpt with a mask permanently on his face, unlike the previous Batman, which had an extra uncowled head. On the plus side, this figure comes with three swappable lower faces held on by magnets. MIchael Keaton has some very distinctive expressions, and each one of these mouthpieces captures the actor's look. The cowl itself is very accurate in its shape, and it has the unique texture that the movie's rubber headpiece had. Sculpt-wise, the costume itself is well-crafted too. It's pretty much a one-piece rubber suit, but it has the same accurate texture as the movie costume. We count the height of the figure as part of the sculpt as well, and this figure definitely seems to be the proper proportion with other figures in this class. It's important to note that he is the exact height he needs to be to fit inside the cockpit of the Batmobile vehicle, also made by Hot Toys. The ears on his cowl are supposed to extend just a bit past the canopy in real life, and they are certainly the right height and proportion in the scale figure too. Overall, this figure resembles the actor and the character very well, and we were pleased with the uncanny likeness. There's no mistaking who this is, and that's a sign of excellent sculpting. So, we gave it a perfect 5.
Sometimes the choice of materials used in a figure like this means you don't have to do a lot of painting. The downside is that what paint you do have must be super clean, with good coloring, and very little slop around the edges. Hot Toys paint applications are always top shelf and unmatched by all but a few toy makers. The paint on the bat symbol and the utility belt is super clean, and they both have nice clean edges. The accessories all have nice clean paint lines as well, with nice metallic gold and silver touches throughout. The little painted details on his hands are nicely done in a contrasting silver. His lower mouth portions all have a nice subtle stubble effect, and the lips and skin tone are very realistic. The bloodstains on the one mouthpiece are done in a nice gloss finish and look amazingly real. Finally, the blackout paint around his eyes is done in a slightly different shade of black, and it really looks like black grease paint. All in all, this is another fine example of scale paint done right, with just the right touches and a super clean finish. It definitely enhances the likeness of the character, which is what it's supposed to do. So we gave this category another perfect 5 score. It's interesting when a figure's sculpt and materials match the reality a little bit too much. One of the actor's main complaints with the costume was that because it's a big rubber suit from head to toe, it's incredibly stiff and difficult to move in. And so it is with this mini costume. The cowl completely covers the head and neck in thick plastic, so the head doesn't move at all. The rubber suit itself is all one piece from the neck down to just below the knees, and there was some movement in the hips, knees, and elbows, so you can pose him in some fighting and crouching stances. The rubber is so stiff, though, that the elbows and knees don't hold extreme poses well, and there are no ratchet joints to hold him in place. And just like the Dark Knight Rises Batman, you can't raise his arms above his chest. However, you can get him into a sitting position, which is important if you want to place him in the driver's seat of the Batmobile. Also, the cape has a thin wire running along the scalloped edges, so you can create some really cool flowing cape poses to simulate superhero kick buttery. This was also our first experience with the parallel eyeball rolling system, which is accessed through a magnetic panel at the back of his head. It's especially important here since the real actor couldn't turn his head very much, so he relied heavily on his side vision to track his opponents, and this can be simulated in the figure by moving his eye sideways. This Batman's purse system is very easy to get to and doesn't need a special tool to move the eyes. So this figure has a pretty even balance of good and bad points on articulation, and the fact that we could seat him in his Batmobile certainly helped his score, so that's why we gave it a 3.5 out of 5. What can we say about this awesome costume? Tim Burton's Batman suit was a huge change from the silk and spandex outfit shown in the 1960s TV series and the comic books. Burton wanted his character to be dark and menacing, yet recognizable, and this scale reproduction really captures that look. The bodysuit itself is one piece, and it's glued together at the back seam, so it's not meant to be removed. The full cape has a similar leather-like texture and is lined with a satin finish on the inside. The belt is also glued together and non-removable, and it has a magnet on the front to hold the grappling gun as seen in the movie. And of course, the unique shape of the bat symbol really stands out on this costume, just as it did on screen. We freely admit that this is our favorite Batman film, and this costume is dead on accurate and amazingly detailed even at this scale. We don't think Hot Toys could have done a better job with this bat suit, and that's why we gave it another perfect 5 score.
Off an awesome display with these cool characters without some iconic props to really draw the viewer in. For this Batman release, they've packed the Bat Vault full of Bruce Wayne's favorite cosplay gadgets.
Where does he get those wonderful toys?
First off, this Dark Knight detective comes with no less than 7 pairs of hands, including the 2 pairs of fists that he comes equipped with out of the box. Moving on to the weapon category, Batman also has his Batarang with attached cord, 1 extendable wrist gauntlet, 1 grappling gun and 2 pieces with a belt clip for the front portion, 3 smoke capsules, 1 timer bomb, 2 ninja throwing stars, 1 very cool movable piton gauntlet, 1 remote for controlling the Batmobile, and a deluxe light-up base with an engraved metal nameplate. Some other accessories that are more accurately grouped in the costume category are the 3 interchangeable mouthpieces, and 3 extra glove blades in case some break off or are lost. All of these scale props are excellently sculpted and painted with clean edges and no paint slop, typical of Hot Toys' top-notch artistry.
Get the car.
Which one?
course, the Batmobile isn't really a prop because it doesn't come in the box, but you can't really have one without the other. The opportunities for this awesome shelf display really opens up when you can display the Batman with his signature ride. We don't have any issues with most of the accessories, except for the base with its yellow bat symbol, which was painted in reverse to Batman's actual logo. We think it would have been more cool to see the unique bat symbol on this movie costume engraved on the base instead. But this nitpicky issue is so small, it doesn't even affect our score. This pint-sized Batman comes with plenty of cool props that would make any scale superhero proud, so we couldn't help but give this category another perfect 5.
We love the photos Hot Toys puts out of its upcoming products. Most of the time, that's all we have until the day the figure arrives. So let's see if this mini Bat Dude lives up to the photos of its prototype. The likeness of the Batman figure and of actor MIchael Keaton is practically identical to the prototype photos. We can't see any difference in the sculpts, even considering we don't really see most of his face. The more noticeable changes are in the paint texture on the props. The paint is much more smooth and clean on the final product than on the prototype, which is a good thing. The textured suit and cape are much smoother on the final product too, which is also a good thing. Where the changes aren't so good is on the belt and the bat emblem. We remember the belt in the movie to be a more golden color, and the prototype images show that golden tone. The shipped figure, however, has a plain yellow color, almost the same plain yellow as the final toy's bat emblem. And speaking of which, the bat emblem in the movie had a glossy finish on the black and yellow colors, which was replicated on the prototype, but the final product has a flat finish on its bat emblem, making it stand out far less. These changes to the belt and emblem make the overall product seem more cheap and toy-like than a collectible figure should at this price point. Even with all these other details in comparison, it was still big enough for us to knock the score down a little bit, so we gave it a solid 4 out of 5. We were thrilled to add this figure to our collection, and Hot Toys did a fantastic job replicating this character in 6 scale. The multitude of props and extra faces really makes this figure stand out, and even with the little issues, it deserves an honored place on any collector's shelf. So that's why we gave the Batman a 4.5 out of 5.
If you want to see more figures like these, you can visit Sideshow Collectibles at SideshowToys.com, or you can visit Hot Toys' own webpage at HotToys.com.hk. Our question this time around is, if you could dress as Batman for Halloween in whichever version, from the movies or from the television shows, who would you go as?
So until next time, this is Super Dupert.
And this is Pop Tart.
Thanks so much for watching and stay tuned for more awesome reviews. Same bat time,
same bat channel.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman. Hey guys, I'm Batman. Well, at least I was.
She's gone.
You stay here on the ground. Keep the fight.
Excuse me, Mr. Hulk guy. Your fly's undone.
This is Mac Daddy-O.
And I'm Batman.